Are you filming without me, Gary?
No, I'm going to get one in at some point. I've got a real problem here. I'm trying to put a thread on it. You told me it needs about two or three threads hanging out the back.
That's right.
But my guide has now caught where the bend is, but that's exactly the position. Can you help me out?
Yep, I can get you out of this, Gary.
Okay.
So we'll take this off.
So my guide wouldn't get round this bend here. It stopped, obviously, as it wanted to go round. So I can't get enough threads on this end for what I need. So how do I get out of that jam?
Yep, so you've got it going. What we need to do is swap it round.
Oh.
Flip it round, use it without the guide this time, just so we can get enough of the thread on there.
So by losing the position the guide was in,
yep.
Obviously it's going to be a bit more tricky now, isn't it? Because yep. Obviously we haven't got that guide to stop it going all over the place. So do you have to be a bit slower?
Yep, just a bit more tricky to get it going, but once we're going, we're okay.
Ah, so if you stop there, you can clearly see, can you, I've got a lot more straight conduit now before I come round this bend.
Yeah.
That's a good tip, that is, but of course, you have to be quite slow when you're doing it. So I probably only need a couple of three threads, so another once round, maybe you'll be there.
Yeah, I think we'll be okay there.
So the problem now is you obviously don't want it to obviously give you a wonky thread, do you? So that's why it's best to go that little bit slower, yeah. Isn't it? So if we pull that off. So let's see if those threads are half the length of a coupler or the length of a spouted box. That looks perfect to me for the length.
Yep.
Shall we try a spouted box? Obviously we'd need to ream it, but just for the length, you want to put it on the outside there. So you're going to ream it out for us and wipe it over. So just lay it on there. Perfect.
Yep.
And that means I'm as close as I possibly can to that bend by using your little tip there. Well, Jake is the gift that keeps on giving. Just remind us of that top tip.
So Gary, you were struggling to thread this piece of conduit because the bend is so short, the guide wouldn't get around the bend. So I took it off, reversed it and threaded it without the guide.
Yeah, you did. So again, I wouldn't recommend it as your first port of call. Always use the guide if you can. But of course, it was that top tip where I was too close, the guide won't go around the bend, and we just reversed our stocks and dies round. Thank you very much for that. But as always in this series, it's your feedback that's driving the video. So if you want to see something, leave it in the comments and we'll make these videos. Actually, Jake will make them. And as well, he'll get back to every single comment.